शांति मैम,
म्यूट माइक।
शांति
शांति मैम, इंट्रोड्यूस द चीफ गेस्ट शांति मैम, जस्ट यू टेल इंट्रोडक्शन चीफ गेस्ट।
शांति मैम, ओवर टू यू मैम।
मैम
திருப்பூர் குமரன் காலேஜ் ஃபார் விமன். She had completed her set in March 2018. She had more than 14 years of teaching experience for UG and PG. Under her guidance, 5 candidates had completed their MPhil degree. She had presented many papers in national and international conferences in various colleges in her field. Also, she published papers in international journals of computer science. We are very fortunate to have you with us, ma'am.
Over to you, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. I finished, Anita ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Mohana Priya, ma'am. Over to you, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the nice introduction. And thank you for this opportunity given by the Bishop Ambrose College. And I thank the patron principal, Dr. A. Peter Raj, sir, the convener, the head of the department, Dr. R. P. Gayatri Devi, and the coordinators, Ms. Anita and Ms. Avila. Thank you, ma'am. Shall we start, ma'am?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am, you can start, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So let's start the session. As we are departed due to corona, we are more urged to connect to the modern tools for continuing our digital teaching and learning process. And when we see how we can connect to the modern tools, we can divide the digital learning tools into two aspects, either synchronous and asynchronous teaching elements, or synchronous or asynchronous discussion elements. Synchronous elements is the live classes, where we go now as we are connected together in the Google Meet to go for a live discussion. Similarly, we can connect with our students through the live classes, through the variety of platforms which is available. Live delivery and communications can be made, and we can ask the students to enter into a live session and we can deliver. And the next is asynchronous elements, where the students and we are not connected alive, and where we have to go for some so recording sessions of audio, video, or some materials, and you can share them as a PPT recording or screen recording using the PPT recording or screen recording apps, and we can share it in the some platforms of Google Classroom or in some YouTube materials, and we can share the link. And through the asynchronous elements, we have some advantage, disadvantage. in both synchronous and asynchronous, we have both merits and demerits. And to help us, the first platform which helps us is G Suite, which is a digital hub or the collaboration tool which helps us to go for a live session. And through the Google Meet, we can go for session where we do now. And we can share our notes, either it is in a document form or a PPT or anything. We can share through the Google Drive. And we can assign the assignment to the students through classrooms and also through the Google Drive. Even we can perform quiz surveys and polls and feedbacks, grade sheet. So through Excel, Google Sheet, we can perform the grade sheet. And Google Calendar, we can schedule a meet. And Google Forms, we can go for surveys. And Google Docs for many documentation purpose and very additional features in addition to the MS Word, we can go for text to voice conversion and so on. And even you have Jamboard, especially very useful for the Mac staff, where they can go for some drawings, etc. And the in addition to that, the G Suite, we have MS Teams. MS Teams is Microsoft Teams, where we can go both for synchronous and asynchronous communication. We can communicate either live, we can have live classes as Google Meet, and also for synchronous class as Google Classroom. If we can collaborate in the classroom, personalized learning, again assignments, quiz, what are all we do there, we can do it even in MS Teams. And what thing we can do in the live class when we take, there are many platforms available, many video conferencing tools available. I've just taken three tools to compare: Google Meet, Zoom, and a Microsoft team. So in Google Meet, the maximum people we can connect, if it is a normal G Suite basic account, everyone who has a Gmail account can call for a Google Meet with 100% can accommodate in a meet. And if it is a G Suite business, 150 people, and if it is G Suite enterprise license, 250 people can accommodate. This is the maximum limit, and so 100 people. And if you go for some pay premium version by paying the amount, you can go for 500 people to accommodate. Microsoft Teams, 250 people. And when you take the time limit, Google Meet doesn't have any limits on the length of the calls. But in Zoom, you have 40 minutes. And if you go for a paid version, even you can go for 24 hours live class. Microsoft Teams also doesn't have any limits on the length of the calls which we make. Screen sharing in Google Meet, only one person may share their screen at a time. And Zoom, the meeting host can allow multiple people to share the screen at a time. In MS Teams, admins can configure who all can share the screen. So in addition to these three terms I have just taken for limitation, in addition to that, there is many other tools, GoToWebinar, Gypsy, and et cetera, et cetera. There are many more tools available. And in the asynchronous learning elements, these are the synchronous learning elements. The next which we take is asynchronous learning elements. This doesn't require that we have to meet on a specific time. As we have scheduled today that we have a meeting at 5 to 6. Likewise, we doesn't want any particular time that we have to meet as per that time. And we can meet accordingly. It doesn't mean that there is a meeting at all. We can just give our audio video. We can give our recorded presentations. Self-paced online code. We can create using the synchronous elements. We can give our audio video presentations. We can give demos. We can give self-paced online courses. We can give downloadable documents, and asynchronous discussion forums can be made. Audio video files, course pages, quizzes, activities. These are all the contents which we can make. And there are certain disadvantages of asynchronous learning. It needs more time and deep processing for practice and feedback. And because when we want to create a video and we want to edit a video or some audio content or prepare a material, rather than speaking, we have to spend more time on creating the content. So it takes really more time and you need deep processing for that. And the learning curve and time resources is very important. To create a 30-hour lecture for a video, we need some more time in addition to that to deliver. It is not like just you walk into a class, you deliver your lecture and come back. So we need some work, and also we need some time. And other important factor is file size and bandwidth hosting issues. The students in the rural areas, they will not be able to download the video content which we share. There are bandwidth and file size issue also matters. Now we have a Slido. Let's get into a live poll. So I am taking the Google Slides to go for a polling now. So like this, I'm taking the session, I'm creating a session. So I'm adding a live poll so that now we can answer for this poll. I'm asking you that the tools which you are familiar with. So I'm adding the options that Google Classroom and the second option as Moodle. The next is Microsoft Teams. And next is Book Widgets. So hope you all participants will be able to view the question now in the slide, in your screen. In the left side of your slide, you can see the QR code, and below the QR code, there is a code to join in Slido.com. If you have a QR code reader, directly if you scan the code, you can answer the questions. Or if you don't have QR code scanner, just don't worry. Go to slido.com and enter this code P873. You can answer this question. So please, my humble request is if you answer this, it will be easy for me to proceed. Either you can go to the QR code scanner or slido.com. You will get this question, you can answer. So two members have answered, three. Five have answered. Six. It is not a tough question, and it is nothing I'm going to do with that. Just it will be helping me to proceed. So 12 members have answered. Thirteen, fourteen, fifteen, sixteen. Many are familiar with Google Classroom, this poll shows. Moodle 25%. Moodle 24, my MS Teams 12, and Book Widgets. So out of 18 members, 19. Okay, thank you. 20 members have answered, and the maximum know about Google Classroom. Thank you, participants. Thank you for your reply. likewise in the Slido, we can integrate the technology so that likewise we can go for a poll. When we even go for synchronous communication with students where we schedule for a class for 1 hour or 40 minutes, we can trigger the students to come out with their aspects like the Slido. Very simple, we have to go to the slides. We have to integrate a poll using the Slido. We are bringing the Slido into our slides and we can ask them to share their idea. Likewise, this is just to integrate or making the participants to be active in our session. And next is online course creation is one of the asynchronous activity which we can do. We can import the subject PPT to the Google Slides. Whatever subject we handle, we can import it into the Google Slides and you can present it. We can do all the basic editing operations as themes, transitions, etc. You can insert your even YouTube video. Whenever you give in video content with the audio content, it makes it as a course. So you can include video content, YouTube video content, and this feature is not available in any other presentation software except this Microsoft Slides, sorry, Google Slides. Then you can skip a particular slide, and author feedback is another important task. You can go for timer features. You can give this particular time. If you want a slide to be present for 5 seconds, you can fix that in that slides. You can present or publish. And at the end, you can add the quiz and you can provide the certificate with the marks or the percentage they acquired through the email. And while you go for this Google Slides add-on, you can use the equation editor. This equation editor will be very useful for maths people to give the equations. So you have to install this equation editor add-on because this is not available inbuilt in the slide. You have to include or install this add-on. As this red mark shows, we have to include it. Once you install, you open, you can see the equation editor at the right side. Those who use the LaTeX code will be very familiar. If you are, I have entered the equation x squared by y squared plus 2ab plus 3ac. Those are very familiar with the LaTeX would know you cannot enter the equation as it is. They have to generate the LaTeX code, for example, slash fract x squared x2 by x2 y2 plus 2ab plus 2ac. This is the format which you have to enter into LaTeX. So thus it will be generated here as it is. And once if you give that, this can be included in the slide. So this tool will be, this add-on, equation editor add-on, will be useful for maths people and also those who are involved in research and other activities for using the research publications using the LaTeX. And next add-on I said is Slido polling, asked in a few minutes back, which we have go for a live polling, through which you can very import the very simple task is you have to, once you install the add-on, you will be getting the Slido and this Google Slide. Then you can go for the present with the Slido, and the question will be given to the slide, presented to the slide. With these tasks, we can go for an online course creation. This is one of the sample course which we created and uploaded in the website. As per our instructions of our principal madam in our college, most of the faculties have created this online course of all our subjects which we handle and we have installed. So once if you click on this link, it will take you to the course. And from that course, I have given the video content also, which I have created and uploaded in YouTube. And that after students attending that video content and the materials which I have added in the slide, they can go to the class. This is the college website. And this, once I click the link, it takes me to here. And when I click this link, it will take me to the course. So the students will enter. See, this is a presentation. You can go for every slide one, slide two, etc. So they can, in the slide two, slide three, next slide, I have given the video content. So this is a video I have uploaded from YouTube. So once I click the play, students click the play, they'll be able to view the audio content. so they can listen to the class throughout this video. And even this video, we can like to insert, if it is a 50 minutes video, we can insert just a 30 minutes clip or 20 minutes clip. That kind of feature has been enabled here. And similarly, we can go to all other, the student can view all the slides, they can attend the course. And at the last slide, they'll be giving, they are given a quiz. Once they attempt the quiz, it will be taken to the Google Forms. They'll be answering the question. And once they score above 40% by submitting, they'll be getting a certificate. This is a simple activity which we can do and which we have done in our college. And again, back to the presentation. Video creation from a PowerPoint slide. This is a very simple concept where we can go for a video creation. How to create a video. When you want to present in the previous slide, what I have done is that this, I have given only the PPT content as a video. So there you can create this video from the existing PowerPoint itself. But that alone doesn't help all the time. But because if I want to speak something other than the content of the PPT, I want to go beyond that. If I want to open the browser, I want to show some other programming tools. This PPT slide, video creation from PPT slide alone will not help. I'll show you the demo after completing this slide presentation of how to create a video from this PowerPoint slide. And next is Google Classroom. I have seen from the poll that many of you are aware of the Google Classroom. It is really a free collaboration for the teachers and learners. Teachers can create online classrooms, ask students to attend the class and give out assignments. So we can share the teaching materials, PDF material, document, video, and link everything in Google Classroom. We can even evaluate, grade, and return the assignment. The only thing, we don't have live classes, but that is possible only if we integrate it with Google Meet. So two ways to use the Google Classroom, from the website or from the Android mobile. But that is really basic difference. We can use in both, but if you use from the Android phone, you cannot obtain all the features which you use from the desktop. Some features are being disabled. Even you cannot grade the assignment in Android phone. So for that, you have to use only the desktop version. Even from the Android phone, you can do, if you select from the settings option that you should select the desktop version. You should go to the browser, but not to the Android app. From the app, you'll be getting only very less number of features. If you go to the browser, you'll be getting all the features in the desktop. So what is, this is the method of creating class. You should enter the classroom, click the create button, you can create a class. And once the code is given, you can share the code with your students through mail or WhatsApp. You can invite the student even through the mail. Two methods. First, you can share the code. Second, you can invite the method through the email. They'll be joining the class. Once you enter the class, there are four tabs: stream, classwork, people, grade. This is all. I'll just enter into a demo after this presentation. From here, we can create the assignment. Stream, we can give the announcement. And in the people, we can see who are all the students in the classroom. And grades, we can go for grades. But you cannot find this grade option in the Android app. You have to go only to the browser. And this is the way you are giving an assignment. Assignment on Linux, I just to title what is the instructions for which class and for all the students and what is the points. So once a student submit back the assignment, you can go for grade. You can enter the marks here. Then overall marking you can see, and even you can find the students who are missing, students who didn't submit the assignment, and student who done late. Here there are two red marks, red oval. So the first, this particular person has submitted late, and this person had not submitted it. And you can also not only give a manual assignment where we have to go and grade each and every student, we can also go for a quiz assignment as we do in the form. So the quiz assignment will be automatically valued and the marks will be calculated by itself, and we can open the responses and see what are all the responses answered by the students. The next is book widgets. Book widget is also a LMS system where you can create widgets. You can handle games and you can create quiz. And it is not very simple as forms. We can go for many multiple options, fill-ups, match the following questions can be given in the quiz, and many options have been given where you can go for interactive exercises and graded, automatically graded tests. So this is also a very interesting tool where you can work with. So this is how you can create the widget using the book widget. And the next is screen recording. So this is the way how you are going to record your content. So as I said, when you want to enter into asynchronous communication, the synchronous mode, we should go for some video. When you want to go for video, you have to go for screen recording. So screen recording, there are both softwares for mobile and for desktop. If you want to convert your content into video from your mobile, you can do it very easily. There are a lot of recording apps available. Mobizen is a famous app which runs on the Android phones with the versions KitKat or above. So now we have gone till Oreo, and now get Oreo we have crossed. So this 4.4 KitKat below Android phones, are very few people will be using, I think so. And record, we can record a mobile device screen in full HD and create the content to the, and we can share to the world. And we can use the FaceTime feature to create more interactive videos. When we want to create a video, we can, if we wish, we can include our face in the video. That is available and even in the mobile recording apps and also in the desktop recording apps. So this is movies in a screenshot. So when you enter, most of the recording apps will have the same features. Record, they'll be having this record option, circle menu, capture the screen. So next is AEZ screen recorder app. This also records your screen with audio. So this is the right circle. If you watch that, it's getting all these options. Due recorder app. Due recorder app is other recording app with this appearance. Once you click on this record button, it starts recording. And after recording, if you give save, it automatically saves into your gallery. And other recording is X Recorder, Loom, X Recorder for mobile. So there are 3-4 recorders and many more recorders even available. I have just shown you the sample. If you go to the Play Store, you can do a lot of recorders available. And the next screen recording software is for Windows. The first is Loom. Using Loom, you can capture the screen, voice, face, and instantly share the videos. It works on Windows, Mac, and iOS platforms. So there are pros and cons in this Loom. So pros is it records up to 1080 pixels and it allows for live notations, can record the screen and webcam. This is the pros or positive aspects of this Loom. The cons is there is no such post editor. It free version puts your videos on Loom for storage rather than your compute storage. So if you go for a free version, you'll be getting only few advantages. Screencast-O-Matic is a famous editor of Windows. It allows to make recordings from screen or also in the webcam. If you want to speak alone and you don't have any presentation, you can directly record on your face and your voice and you can go for publishing that video. And if you have some recordings from your screen, you can record it that using the Screencast-O-Matic also. So then after creation, we can upload it to you. After ma'am, I'm getting some audio disturbances. You can upload the videos directly to YouTube from Screencast-O-Matic. Once our video is ready, you can directly upload to YouTube and also upload videos to screencast-o-matic.com to the direct server host. There are some pros and cons. Pros make recordings up to 15 minutes in length.
Excuse me, madam. Slide is not visible.
Excuse me. Let me present again.
Hello, ma'am. It was visible. Only those who have pinned to your presentation, they can view.
No, no, is it visible, ma'am?
No, ma'am, the screen is not visible, ma'am.
If in between someone enters, my presentation will go automatically. So their presentation will come. Now is it visible, ma'am?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Only name only is coming.
I'm presenting again, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am, it's visible.
Yes, ma'am, it's visible, ma'am.
Ma'am, only your screen is visible.
Okay, ma'am. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. So we have seen the screen recording. Screencast-O-Matic is one of the famous screen recorder for Windows. It allows to go for more recordings from screen or even the webcam. We can upload videos to YouTube directly from the Screencast-O-Matic or to the screencastomatic.com free server host. There are some pros and cons. Pros that it makes recordings up to 15 minutes in length with the free version, limited options of for publication with free version. Most of the screen recording options gives limited features to the free versions. Only for the paid and premium versions, they give complete features. But maximum, we can record up to 15 minutes in most of the available recording softwares. And if you want to go for a particular topic for half an hour or 40 minutes, you have to give it into divisions. You have to record 4 times for a video if you want to go for 1 hour class. So that is the major drawback. Only few recording softwares gives 1 hour duration or unlimited durations for the free versions. If you go for paid version, you can get all those except very few. And the paid version is little inexpensive in Screencast-O-Matic. The cons is watermark is visible on videos made with the free versions. You can see the watermark, and recording computer audio requires Windows Vista or later versions. Camtasia is other software, screen recording software for the Windows. So there are two components in the Camtasia recording. So Camtasia recorder, it is a separate tool for capturing screen audio and video. So Camtasia editor is a feature to edit video capture. For example, we have gone for a live session now, and if I wish, I can upload this, but if I want to cut certain features, I'm asking in between, am I audible? If I want to cut those cuttings, we have to go for some editor. We cannot publish as it is. We have to cut those features. For editing of a video, we can have the Camtasia editor. For recording, you have Camtasia recorder. And for editing the videos, we have to go for some editors which is available. So there are some pros and cons here also. The positive aspects is you can record on multiple video and audio tracks. It is easy to incorporate animated items. Google Drive integration is available. You can directly upload it to the Drive. Free app is available to record videos on mobile devices and transfer to Camtasia for editing. And cons, demo of full software is only free for 30 days. Users are prohibited from creating videos for commercial purpose when using the free version. And this is a Bandicam other screen recording software. Bandicam I'm using to record for uploading in the YouTube, but you can record only up to 10 minutes. I'm just giving only small tips regarding this online e-content creation in the YouTube channel. So for this, I'm using this Bandicam. It doesn't have much editing features and all. And I'm using only the free version. You can edit only 10 minutes recording. It records full screen. Even you can include your, using webcam, you can include your face, a part of screen. and external video devices such as webcam and game console. There are some pros and cons here also. Here you can draw, add text and take screenshots while recording. So you can have the mouse pointer, you can adjust the pointer. Now when the mouse, I'm just moving the mouse here. If I want this mouse pointer to be a circle or a triangle or different colors, I can go for that option in this. Most of the editors have that option. And you can have some mouse effects, click effects and animations while recording. You can add logo to capture the screen. You can go for voice mixing, lightweight package. It is a very lightweight package. It doesn't have much use. When you record for 10 minutes, the recording MB size is very, very less. It doesn't give the huge MB size, and limited video output formats, only MP4 or AVI format is there, but doesn't have inbuilt editor. That is a major drawback. If I want to edit a certain part of the video, it is very difficult. It just gives only the recording aspect. Who wish to record only few content without editing options and a less size. If I don't want too much MB or GB, I want within 30 MB, you can go for that. So now we can enter into the live demo of these recordings in classroom. And YouTube is nothing but you can create a channel in YouTube using a Gmail account. You can log in and you can create a channel, and you can even choose a name. That's all. Your channel is ready. And how to post your videos on YouTube? After creating a channel, it's time to post videos. Before anything else, we need to record a video. After the video is ready, and it is, if it is edited, you can post it on your channel. So this is a channel which we have created last month, and it is Modular Classroom, the name I have given, and it is a YouTube studio. If you enter into the studio, you can look into the what are all the videos you have uploaded and how many people have looked in here. You can go for channel analytics, etc. You can upload videos from the top right corner. Upload videos, you can see here, and also even you can go live. Then once your recording is finished, you can select the files from this place. Fill the basic information about your video, such as title, description, tags, what is the title of your video, what is the description, what are all the tags you want, and what is the video thumbnail which you want to select, which should be appearing as first one. And once it is done,
like me, no. Home is not good.
Click done on the upper right corner. Then it's done. Your video will be posted on the YouTube. So I have attached the sample links here. So these videos I have created and I have uploaded. I'll give you this PDF document. You can refer it. Now we can enter into. The demo session.
Hmm. Anita madam, no audio.
Sir, kindly wait, sir. She will join with us now. She got disconnected. She will join now, sir. She will start with a live demo in few minutes. Participants, kindly wait.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, ma'am.
PPT will be shared in the WhatsApp group and feedback link will be sent at the end of the session. Participants, kindly wait for 2 minutes. Speaker is joining now. Kindly wait, please.
Sorry for the interruption, ma'am. I got hanged out. Are you able to view my screen, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. No problem, ma'am. You can continue, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. So when we go for some recording, I'll open a PPT for showing you how to record a PPT. So let it load, ma'am. I'll enter and also open the Bandicam to show the external recording. Loading. I'm giving yes. In case I'm just show, I'll copy only this particular slide to show how to give a recording in the PowerPoint. So I'm just taking only one single slide. I'm pasting that slide from here. If I want to add the audio content and convert it into a video, just go to the slideshow. Go to the PowerPoint. Take your Gator slides ready. Go to the slideshow and give record slideshow option. So once you give the record slideshow, now you can see the record button at the top left corner with the round circle mentioning as record. So here we can give, if I want to include the webcam, I can turn on the camera. So if I turn on, you can find my face which is viewed at the bottom. If you don't want the webcam, you can turn off. If you want, you can include your video with the audio. Now, whatever I speak, it is recording. If I want to record, I should give record. You can look into the timer, 3, 2, 1. Now the recording starts. Whatever I speak from this timer, it gets recorded. Now the screen and my audio is recording. If you want, you can include your video. If you don't want, you can leave your video. And once it is, if you feel this content is okay, your presentation is okay, you can give stop. And then if you move back, now I have entered into the slide, you can see a speaker at the bottom of the slide. This means your audio is added. If you want to check whether your audio is right, again you have to go for the slideshow from beginning. So now the video recording is done. Now your file is ready with your audio content, but it is not yet converted into video. If you want to convert into video, you should go to the file option, give export. Once you want to export, you have to give as create, sorry, I have selected as create PDF. It is not actually PDF. I want to give file, export, create a video, and I should select create video. and I should give as presentation where I want to save. Let me select the same folder, e:webinar. I am giving the name as presentation one and giving save. So now the file is, see, you can look into the task bar at the bottom, creating video presentation 1.mp4. The files which the PPT converts into video file, you will get extension as .mp4. You can select the file from the location which I have given. Now it is completed 50%. If you look into the task bar, we can note, I have only one slide and I have just only one 10 seconds of speech. But normally PPT recordings which you get will be of little high MB. The size will be of huge size. Normally audio video content will be taking high quality and data size. So now it is ready. Now it is converted. You can go to the webinar folder and I can give sort by, because I have to search for the name. I am giving date modified so that I can find the presentation in that particular specified folder. It is converted into video file. Once I click play, your video file is ready. So this is playing. Just a sample one slide again. So audio is also. That's all. So we can convert into audio. I have made the audio content and also I created the MP4 file. This kind of mechanism doesn't suit in all kind of presentation. For example, if you are handling a lab paper, I should teach how it works. If I go to, I want to go to that. If I want to go to the Google classroom and I want to say how it works and I want to record that. Here, this PowerPoint presentation doesn't help. There, we have to go for some other recording, external recording. So what I have is I am opening the Bandicam here. So this Bandicam is a recording which I have told in my presentation. So in this recording, to record, I should go for Rec. So once if you click this Rec button, the recording will be starting. So I'm giving Rec. So again, timer starts. So I enter into the Google Drive. So you can record. So to stop. So to start recording, I'm taking the opening the Bandicam recording, external recording, video recording option. I'm opening. I'm clicking the Rec button to start recording. You can view the recording timer starts now. So you can see the seconds increase 2, 3, 4, 5. So now the record, it's getting recorded. If you open the any site or any lab programming tools, if you want to explain, you can go to that. I'm opening the Google. I want to explain something. You can make the recording. Again, come back to the body. I'm giving stop. So now the recording stops. To open the particular folder which is created, now the audio and the screen which is being displayed, converted into a video and it is shown and it is saved as a file automatically by the Bandicam. See, these are all the files created. The lastly created file is one which I'm clicking on. Once you click on, the video file gets open. So this is how we can go for some external recording options. So now I'll share the file. I'll also tell you about book widgets and Google Classroom. So you can select the classroom from here. So this is my classrooms. The overall settings can be controlled from this dashboard. You can select the classes which you are enrolled as a student and which you are as a teacher can be seen from this dashboard, and you can change the settings of notifications and the etc. Some other settings, if you go to the settings, you can see that you can control every time you need notifications, what is the profile picture, etc. Again, come back, you can enter into any particular class. Streams, you can give a lot of announcements in the class. Now this class is active. I have posted a YouTube video which is created. So this video is created and posted by me in this channel, in the same channel which I have created. And I've shared the link in the stream. So this is an announcement where you're giving. And you can go to the classwork. You can create an assignment by clicking the create button. You can create a normal assignment or a quiz assignment. If you go for a quiz assignment, you can give using a Google Forms. If I select a Google Form, quiz assignment, you have to give the title for what students, two classes I'm selected. For you can select for all the students in the class. Here there are around 40 students in this class, and if you want to include, you can include all the students, or specifically to the remedial and slow learning students if you want, we can include. And points of the Google Form, 100 marks or 20 marks, on what is the due date, when they have to submit, what is the topic, etc. And you can include rubric is a special division of the assignment marks. So if you're assigning 100 points, 25 marks for the syntax, 25 marks for example, 50 marks for explanation, that division. If I explain, that will be beyond the time limit. So I will be attaching you the links in the PPT which I'm going to share you. So you can look into that also. And after posting the assignment, you can control the students who are all inside the class. I'm the only teacher. If I wish to add some other co-teachers, I can invite them. And these are all the students. If any other students beyond my class enters, I can remove them. And grades, you can grade the student's assignment. So I have given 4 assignments so far. And who are all the students submitted? What are all the marks I have awarded? Still, I have not, if I take any particular assignment, click. Once you click turned in, assigned and graded. So 17 students, there are 33, 17 plus 16, there are 33 students in the class. 17 students have submitted the assignment, 8 students have assigned and still they have not entered into the class to submit the assignment. 8 students graded. I have marks, I have given the marks for these 8 students. For example, if I want to award the marks for all the students, so I'm selecting the particular student. So it will take to the assignment of the student. So the student have submitted. I'm opening the next student. She has scanned the written document. I'm looking into that. So how much marks I can award. So once I feel if I give it is value of 39 or something, I'll be giving the marks. Okay, if I want to add any private command, I can give. I can post the command. And once when you click on the return button, the assignment will be returned to the student. Return. So the assignment is returning. So after returning, if you come back and see, one initially it was 17 students turned in, now it is 16 because I've graded one, so graded count increased. If I value all these students' marks, so the graded count will increase and turned in count will be reduced to 0. So this is a way which we can grade, but as I said earlier, this grading option you cannot do in Android mobile phones. If you want to use an Android mobile phone, you should go to the browser, Google browser, Chrome browser, and from browser you can select to the go to the Google Classroom. Normal mobile, in the normal mobile, go to the Chrome browser and give Google Classroom. Classroom.google.com, if we select, it will give the option of grading. But in the app, we don't have that particular feature. So this is the place where we are giving the assignment grade, etc. And still more, there is a division called rubric, but I don't think the time will not be enough. You can look into the contents which I'm going to share you. This is about the Google Classroom. So here you can even go for live classes, but only when you integrate this. So you can go to the calendar, you can schedule. So I'm entering into the calendar, Google Calendar. I'm going to the calendar. If I wish, I want to have a class meeting, I want to schedule to take a particular class. So if I want to schedule it on coming Saturday, so I can go click on that, add a title, class meeting or class session, I can give it. And you can add it, you can save the event, save. So I can copy the information from here. Event link, I can copy. So here you can have the link. So if you click this copy button, the Google Meet time is copied. So from here, I can post it to the students in the classroom, in the stream, or in the, even you can post it in the assignment session also. You can go to the people, sorry, classwork. I'm submitting as an assignment. So the students should attend the class meeting. I'm giving class meeting. So I'm giving instruction, all are expected to attend. Expected to attend session. So here, if you click on the add, you will be having four links, Google Drive, link, file, and YouTube. I should paste it as a link. So I'm clicking the link, I'm pasting the meet link, and giving the add link. So the class video meeting is published. Once if I publish assign, this assignment will be published to the students. So class meeting. So once they see the meeting, they'll be asking, what is the meeting? I have also given the class meeting link. So 33 students are assigned to a class meeting, 0 students attended it. So nobody has attended the meeting because it is scheduled on coming Saturday. So once they start the link, they join the meeting, you can take the class, then you can wind up the class. If you want a synchronous mode of live class, we can go for this option. So I don't want, because the students will be coming, so I'm deleting. So next is grades, settings. You can control other settings, class settings, general settings, grading settings, everything we can control through the settings. So these are all the four options which is available. And you can create interesting quiz assignments also, but that too I can't explain here. If you are familiar and if you are using, it's very good. I have attached the link also here, because quiz assignment creation is normal quiz which we do in Google Forms. So this is the blank quiz. If you click on that, it will take you to the Google Form design. You can give a quiz, set a question from this Google Forms, and you can post it there. Then the students will be attending the quiz questions and they'll be able to answer. And I wish to show that quiz question grade, which is, I didn't grade it, but I have given this as a Google form. So they have answered these questions and I've got the score. I have got the score. So that score, I can open it in the grades tab. For taking the marks, I should go to the grades tab. Go to the grades tab, one mark test. So these students have attached. So that for that, I should open the Google form. But again, it will take time. I have shown you in the presentation. Okay, now this is about Google Classroom. Coming to the book widgets. So book widgets, you can create an account of free of cost. You can enter into your account. So this is what I've created. Here you can go to the create widget. Create widget. There are a lot of options. Even you can create games. Look into the test and review, flashcards, worksheet, whiteboard, and quiz timeline worksheet you can create. If you take quiz itself, there are a lot of options available. Lot and lot of options is available in the quiz. You can add a question. That question have a lot of options with beyond the Google Forms where we do text with multiple choice question. See, you can have the multiple choice question. Add a question. Again, you can have a single line question, multi line question, rich text question, fill in the blanks, mark sentence, drag words, fact words, fill in the table, question table, annotate picture, whiteboard question, photo, lot and lot of options are available. With just a single question, we have lot of options in book widgets. Even the max, they have the whiteboard question. They can give you a max questions in the whiteboard. Then you can have the my widgets. You can create the games also here. So you can create any kind of quiz, flashcards. Go to the create, which if you click on that, you can create games, bingo card, crossword, hangman, embed third party. Even if just after creating this quiz or games, you can post it to the Google Classroom. That integration is available for the book widgets with the Google Classroom. So even you can embed third party PDF viewer. So that's it's about, we have to work a lot with book widgets. So I wish to share this content to you. Sorry, I will open in Drive. So I'm posting in the chat box. Once you click on that, you can view the presentation. Hope you will be able to open this presentation here. So once you click on that, you can download and use this PDF. I have also attached all the links in the end of the PDFs, PDF file. You can use it. So hope we have come to the end of the session. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Do you have any other questions? Now let's enter into the question session.
Ma'am, there are a few questions in the chat box.
Okay, ma'am. Sure, ma'am. I'll send the PPT in the WhatsApp group. Karuna Lakshmi ma'am is asking. I'll be sharing it. And Anita ma'am, can you get me the questions?
Yes, ma'am. One second.
Okay, ma'am. Paramjit Kumar sir is asking about rubric in the Google Classroom. I'll be sending in the link. I have attached it as a separate link in the PDF I have shared you. Paramjit Kaur sir, I have given the rubric link also in the PDF which I have shared you now. You can click on that link for rubrics. You can get a good idea on rubrics. Someone is asking how to merge Bandicam video and PPT. To merge, you just can open your PowerPoint slide and you can start record. Just press the record button on the Bandicam. Take the Bandicam, give record. Your timer starts. It will be recording automatically. Now I can open my PPT. You go for the PPT and you can start recording. So my once my PPT opens, it will be recorded. Not only once the timer starts, now it is recording. For the past 11 seconds, it is recording. So this PPT will be recorded. And this PPT once will be recorded till you speak, your audio and the video content in the PPT will be recorded. Once you click stop, recording stops, you can get open the content. Any other questions, ma'am?
There is one question, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is it possible to calculate standard deviation and mean from Google Forms collected using Google Classroom, ma'am?
Google, no, ma'am. Even for calculation of standard, you have to take it to an Excel and you can calculate there, ma'am. You can download the Excel sheet. All the data which you have collected will be given only as a Google sheet. You can download the Google sheet and we can apply the formula in Excel and we can calculate, ma'am. Directly we cannot, and you can download the sheet and you can go to the Excel and you can calculate.
Ma'am, another one.
Okay, ma'am.
Google Classroom, is it possible to conduct MCQ test?
Sure, ma'am. That's what I've shown. It is, go to the forms, go to the classroom, go to the forms. You can click on the class. You can go to the class, ma'am. MCQ test only with the aid of the Google Forms. It is linked and it is interrelated with each other. We can go to the class, go to the classwork, create an assignment or a quiz assignment. And there are four options: Google Drive, Link, File, and YouTube. Here, you can leave that. You can go for the create and go to the forms. Click on the forms. And it will take you to the Google form. Here we can go for MCQ test, ma'am. Here you can give the multiple choice question. Here if you want to give expand Chrome, you can give the option one, random, only memory, something, and the second option, none, something, whatever option we can want, you can give the option and you can click the send button, go to the link, second option, take the copy, come back to the Google Classroom and you can paste, ma'am. Create, not, I have created, so I'm going to add, I'm giving the file, sorry, not file, it is link, go to the tab, give the link, click the control view, add link. That's it, it gets pasted. So that's what, once the student click the link, it will take them to the MCQ question. It is a very easy task using the Google Form integration with the Google Classroom.
Ma'am, another one. Is okay, it possible to wherever we want?
In the video, pardon me, ma'am? Is it possible to?
Edit.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Is it possible to edit? But Bandicam doesn't provide the feature. You can go for Screencastia and Screencast-O-Matic provide those features. You can go for editing.
Okay. How do we limit one attempt to a student using while conducting an MCQ using Google Forms?
How to limit one attempt to student for MCQ test, ma'am? Just we can go to the Google Forms.
Yes.
Go to the Google Forms, go to the responses, and from the settings, take the settings, limit to one response. Here, once if you check on this limit to one response in the settings, for one Gmail account, they'll be able to give only one response, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening, ma'am.
Ma'am, your session is very nice, ma'am. I have only one doubt, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Tell me, ma'am.
Suppose my PPT is available only in the computer, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Is there any option to record an audio using a mobile, ma'am, Bandicam in mobile, ma'am?
For Bandicam, you don't have Windows. It is only for Windows, ma'am. If you want to record in mobile, you can do using MobiZen, X Recorder, and some other mobile recording apps, ma'am. Easily, we can do in mobile.
Okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Ma'am, and also okay, I have another ma'am.
Tell me, ma'am.
Ma'am, for certificate generation, we are using Certify EM, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Is there any limit for sending certificates, ma'am? 100 respondents, yes, 200
ma'am.
Respondents?
Yes, ma'am. Like only 100 certificates is available for a normal Gmail account, ma'am. If you get any G Suite account, you can go beyond that. But for a normal Gmail account, the limit is only 100 per day, ma'am. For that, you have to go to the next day you will be able to send the remaining certificates. For that option, you have to go to the settings in the Certify EM. I'm showing here, ma'am. Look into the screen. Go to the add-ons, Certify EM.
Okay, ma'am.
From the Certify EM, I don't have any form which is enabled. I should take a form which is already available. Okay. In the form, I'll be telling ma'am, if you take that form, you have to click on the resend certificates and click on the tick option. You have to go to the resend options, ma'am. And then you can send the next day. One day, you can send only 100 certificates. The next day, you can send the remaining certificates using the resend option.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, on the date also, we can send only 100, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. If you got 1,000 responses, you can send all the certificates. It will take 10 days for you to sending the certificates, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, is it consider after 100, ma'am? Also, next 100, it will automatically consider,
yes,
ma'am.
You have to turn on, ma'am. You have to manually go and give the recent certificate. I have attached, created a video and uploaded, ma'am. Go to my YouTube channel, Modular Classroom, 1 week before I have uploaded that video. If you're not clear, you can look into that, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. After I'm seeing the video, I can
go on, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Namaskar, ma'am.
Namaskar, ma'am.
Myself Piyush Parekh. I have one query. That can we restrict the student that we have added only those email IDs? Through that, only the student can log in to our Google Classroom or that book widget.
I can't get you, sir. Please, can you repeat?
Ma'am, in the Google Classroom, I have added 10 students' email ID.
Okay.
Can I restrict that the student can only join through those email IDs only? And they can
email IDs created by student, and email IDs are created by student. Once if you share the code, any student can join if they receive the code. And if they are not your student, you can have an option to remove them, and even you can reset the code in the settings. That option is available.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Ma'am, I have one more query.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, suppose that I want to give a lecture on mobile application development with the students, and I want to share the screen of my Android Studio with the students parallel with the PPT. Can I have any tool to do the same in parallel?
If you want to go for live classes, you're asking.
Yeah, ma'am.
Live classes, if you just click on the present screen, you can, your students can able to view your screen. And either you go for a PPT presentation or any other demonstration, the students will able to view your screen. But only mm-hmm. thing in Google Meet, you have to ping the author in between. There is only one person who can present in a meeting. If anybody starts presenting, then the original presenter's presentation cannot be viewed. So that only it is asked to pin the particular speaker's thing. So you should ask the students not to present, only you should present. Or they have to pin you. If somebody comes in between, they should pin your presentation to make it viewable.
Ma'am, we cannot restrict the student by that they cannot share their screen in the Google Meet.
The admin, who is the creator, who is the host of the Google Meet, they can they can prevent it from giving the admit to enter into the class. Once if you give the admit, even for this Google Meet, the organizers, yeah. Anita ma'am, and they should have given the admit. Only if they have given admit, the around 200 people are able to enter into this Google Meet platform because they are the host. They should give us admit. So if you doesn't wish any student to not enter, you can stop it from giving the admit.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Good evening, madam. Good evening, madam.
Good evening, sir.
Thank you for hands-on training.
Good evening.
Madam. I'm Dr. Khan.
Thank you. Thank you.
Kalahalling University, Virudhunagar District, madam. I have a doubt.
Oh, thank you, sir. Welcome.
I have doubt in Google Meet.
Okay, sir.
Can we share
Google Meet,
yes,
sir?
Madam. Can we share our files through any D colon or E colon, madam, in Google Meet?
Directly D colon, I cannot share. Now I have shared my presentation from the drive, sir. From the drive, we can share. Okay. Now I have shared my link in the chat box. So how it is possible? If you look at the chat box, you can see my content, sir, PPT. Now I have shared it from the Google Drive. From the Google Drive, you get a shareable link and you can share it. From directly from the drive, you cannot share it in Google Drive.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am, another question, ma'am. Ma'am?
Okay, ma'am.
From Dr. Venugopal, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
How to remove the sentence you have passed in Certify EM? How to remove it?
Certify, once if it is, you cannot remove it. But for example, if you, only for 2 persons it has been sent, you cannot roll back that. Rollbacking process is not possible. But for the remaining students, you can prevent it. Go to the, if you make a change in the Google's slide, if you make, if you want to change a change in the certificate, if you directly do it, we can make change. So I'm opening a certificate here. It is in the Google slide. If I have made any mistake here, this is a college certificate. Here, if I want to make any change, I make here so that remaining students who receive the certificate will not be reflected with the mistakes which I have made. But already passed certificates cannot be rolled back.
Okay, ma'am. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Shall we close the session, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. One second, ma'am. Avila, over to you, Avila.
Okay, ma'am. A formal welcome, thanks to you, ma'am.
Saying thank you is more than good manner. A very good evening to one and all gathered here. First of all, I extend my most sincere thanks to Almighty God for making today's session in successful way. On behalf of our college, I extend a really hearty thanks to our chief guest, Ms. Moganapriya, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Application, who spared times from her busy schedule to grace this occasion. Today, we learnt a lot about modern tools, ma'am, and this will surely be going to encourage us in our future events. Thank you, ma'am. My heartfelt thanks to our secretary, Reverend Dr. Father R.D.E. Jerome, and our principal, Dr. A. Peter Raj, for their kindness and encouragement. Thank you, sir. My gratitude to all the participants for your attention and cooperation. Once again, I thank you all. Tomorrow's session will start at 5 p.m. We will meet soon. Thank you.
Thank you, all the
best. Thank you.
And
thank you for your wonderful presentation.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam. Thank you, the Department of Mathematics.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.